Good morning. In our previous lesson introducing conservative and non-conservative forces, we showed that the work done by a conservative force equals the negative change in potential energy associated with that force. What I'm going to do now is slide the integral definition of work into the equation. What we get is the work done by a conservative force equals the integral with respect to x position from position initial to position final of force in the x direction, which equals the negative of the change in potential energy associated with that force. Billy, please rearrange that equation to make it into a derivative instead of an integral.
Absolutely.
Flipping physics.
Okay, remember that the integral means the sum of the areas of an infinite number of infinitesimally small rectangles, in this case with sides f sub x and dx, and we can instead look at the area of only one of those infinitesimally small rectangles, which is just height f sub x times width dx. Then we would also be looking at an infinitesimally small change in potential energy du. We can then rearrange that equation to show that the component of a conservative force in the x direction equals the negative of the derivative, with respect to x position, of the potential energy associated with that force.
Very nice, Billy. Bo, please show that the equation is valid using elastic potential energy.
Sure. That equation, then, is the spring force equals the negative of the derivative, with respect to x position, of elastic potential energy. The equation for elastic potential energy is 1/2 spring constant times displacement from equilibrium position squared. The derivative of that with respect to x position is, well, 2 times 1/2 equals 1, so negative spring constant times displacement from equilibrium position. And that is Hooke's law, or the equation for the spring force, so the equation is valid because we get Hooke's law out of it.
And why is the negative in the equation?
Because the spring force and the displacement from equilibrium position are opposite in direction.
Correct. Thanks, Bo. Bobby, please do the same thing with gravitational potential energy.
Well, the force of gravity equals the negative of the derivative with respect to x position of gravitational potential energy. Actually, that should be with respect to the y position because the force of gravity is in the y direction. And the equation for gravitational potential energy is mass times acceleration due to gravity times height h above the zero line. However, let's use a y instead because that will make it more clear that we are taking the derivative with respect to that variable. The derivative of that equals negative mass times acceleration due to gravity. That means the equation relating conservative force to change in potential energy is valid because we get the equation for the force of gravity out of it. And the force of gravity is negative because the force of gravity is down.
Great. Thanks, Bobby. Now let's work through an example. Let's say we have a conservative force of negative 2.0x plus 2.0x squared, all times unit vector I newtons, that acts on an object as it moves from an x position of 1.0 meters to 2.0 meters. What is the change in potential energy of the object? You may assume this force is the only force acting on the object. Before we begin answering the question, realize when you see the term conservative force, you need to immediately think of the equation conservative force in the x direction equals the negative derivative with respect to x position of the potential energy associated with that force. And realize, this equation is not on the AP Physics C equation sheet, so you need to memorize it. Okay, Billy, please solve the problem.
Certainly. We start with the equation conservative force in the x direction equals the negative derivative with respect to x position of the potential energy associated with that force. Then we can multiply both sides by dx and then take the definite integral of both sides. The left-hand side is the integral with respect to x, so it is from position initial to position final. The right-hand side is the integral with respect to potential energy, so that is from potential energy initial to potential energy final, and that equals the negative of the quantity potential energy final minus potential energy initial, or the negative of the change in potential energy. That's funny. The left-hand side of that equation is the work done by the force, and the right-hand side is the negative of the change in potential energy, which is the equation you started this lesson with. Okay, anyway, multiplying through by negative 1 gives us that the change in potential energy then equals the negative of the integral of the force with respect to position, or the negative of the integral from 1 to 2 of the quantity negative 2x plus 2x squared, all with respect to x. That equals the negative of the quantity negative 2x squared over 2 plus 2x cubed over 3 with the limits from 1 to 2. Before we substitute in the limits, let's simplify to get x squared minus 2x cubed over 3. And substituting in limits gives us 2 squared minus 2 times 2 cubed, both over 3, and then minus the quantity 1 squared minus 2 times 1 cubed, both over 3. That equals negative 4 thirds minus 1 third, or negative 5 thirds, which equals negative 1.7 joules with 2 sig figs. Why is the change in potential energy of the object negative?
Thank you, Billy. And yes, the change in potential energy associated with this conservative force as the object goes from an x position of 1 to an x position of 2 meters is negative. While we do not know much about what is physically going on in this example, because we do not know much about this conservative force, which I completely made up, we do know that the potential energy of the object has decreased in the direction of the motion of the object. What we can do is make a comparison to gravitational potential energy and the force of gravity. In that gravitational analogy, the object has moved down. The force of gravity and displacement of the object are in the same direction, so the work done on the object by the force of gravity is positive. That means the change in gravitational potential of the energy of the object is negative, so the gravitational potential energy of the object has decreased. If you look at the graph of the force in our example, you can see that the conservative force in our example is always in the positive x direction between 1 and 2 meters. Because the displacement of the object is also in the positive x direction, the work done by the force, or the area under the function, is positive. We know the change in potential energy associated with this conservative force equals the negative of that work, which is why the change in potential energy of the object is negative. The potential energy of the object has decreased. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.